What's up, ladies and gentlemen? I am Dylan, the TechnoGiz guy, and today we're going over probably what has become one of my favorite tools in my backpack as an IT guy. What is up, lady bots and general droids? Today, we're looking at the SySpeed USB KVM. I actually heard about this from Wendell at Level 1 Tech. He did a video on a bunch of these, and I picked them up. Since I picked this one up, it has been in my backpack, and it has easily become one of my favorite tools. If you pair this with a couple of HDMI adapters, like HDMI to VGA, HDMI to DisplayPort, stuff like that, and just throw them in your bag with it, you will basically never have a problem getting into a computer. So I'm going to go over to the bench real quick. I'm going to show you guys how to hook this thing up and kind of give you a little once over of it. And then I actually have a real world clip that I took that where I used this on a job site at my day job to accomplish my task. So let's get right to it. Okay, we're going to do this one run and gun style, like in the old days, because I tore apart the bench cam and the bench is a mess right now because I'm working on like 7 projects for some deadlines. But anyway, this is the case that it comes in. It's a really nice little carrying case, hard shell, so it keeps it nice and safe. This is the USB-C cord that it came with. It came with this adapter that takes USB-C and turns it into USB-A. It was clipped onto the cable. You can see here, I cut it off. I didn't like that it was permanently clipped on, so I just quickly cut it off, and now I can just use it. I also, this did not come with it, but I keep it in here just because why not? I keep a little mini HDMI cord in the bag as well. The other thing you get is the KVM itself. Okay, so on this side, you have the target, and this is where you actually are going to like plug in the computer you're trying to control. So you plug in HDMI for the monitor, and you give it USB, and that will give it keyboard, mouse, and USB support. Host side, all you need is the USB-C. So you'll see this in the live demonstration, but you can plug in this HDMI for pass-through if you want it or need it, but you don't need it because this USB-C on the host side will carry video, audio, keyboard, mouse, and flash drive if this switch is in the right spot. So the switch on the top is a 2-position switch, and what it does is it actually switches this USB port on the back between the two sides. So what you can do is throw a small USB key in here with like boot ISOs, and if you need to throw another one on, all you got to do is click it over to your computer, dump the ISO on, click it back over, and boot off of it, and it's that simple. So unlike the nicer, you know, KVM, the nano KVMs and the networked ones, this does not have the ability to image via the device. You have to plug a USB in if you want to get images across. But you can see everything kind of packs up nice and neat into the case. You can just close it up. I usually keep another USB-C cord in here for going to my computer. Right now it's not in there because I took it out for using something else. But luckily, since it's USB-C and not some random proprietary connector, pretty much any cable will just work. It zips shut, so it'll keep it nice and safe. Like I said, it's hard, so you're not going to have to worry about it getting too damaged. And yeah, nice and definitely backpack-sized. Okay, so I'm here on a job site, and I don't actually know, sorry guys, I don't know where this is going to get stuffed into the video, but I have a computer that I'm setting up, and I don't have a monitor or keyboard around, so I've got my little USB KVM. So I'm going to plug in and try to do this one-handed because I don't have a tripod on me. So I'm going to plug this long USB-C cable into the host USB side, and then on the target side I'm going to plug in another USB cable and an HDMI cable. Alright, now I'm just going to plug the HDMI cable into the computer. I'm going to plug this USB-C cable that has an A adapter on the end of it, but I can take it off if I want. Plug that into any of the USB ports. And now I can take the other cord that's over here, this end, and plug it into my MacBook. All right, so plug in the Nano KVM to my laptop via USB-C. Open up their little app. You can do this with a web client too, but I downloaded the app so I have it for offline stuff. For whatever reason, this keeps picking up my mic whenever I use the software. I don't know why. I'm just gonna turn the computer on. Normally I would screen record this, guys, but I'm on a job site right now for my day job and I'm just trying to get this done quickly. But you can see we have video coming up. We can make this full screen if we want. See the little Windows boot up icon. And now that it's loaded in, you can see I have full KVM access to that machine just with that little USB guy. There is an HDMI pass-through on that, so that way you can plug it into another monitor. I don't know why you would need that, but it's there. There's also a USB port on this guy somewhere over here that is toggleable with this switch. So when you hit the switch, it'll change it from going either to your host computer, aka my laptop, or your target computer, aka this server. So that's really nice for like loading ISOs and stuff, because you can't directly load media through like the software. So you have to throw a flash drive into that to load any ISOs or anything. But as like a backpack KVM, that thing is a lifesaver. You pair that with an HDMI to VGA adapter in your backpack and you are golden.
Okay, so there you have it. Little tiny USB KVM that you can take anywhere, fits in your bag. All you gotta do is USB and HDMI to a computer and you get full control to it. I don't know what else to say. These things run for like $50 on their website. I wish they were a little cheaper, but honestly, they're worth every penny. I wanna get another one that's for the rack, like a not USB one. I want to get a nice networked one so I can control everything. If you want to see the video I did where I put a KVM switch in there, that's up here. But yeah, if you do IT work or just work with computers a lot, you should have one of these in your backpack for sure. I'm actually trying to petition my boss to get one for all of our field techs at my day job, because it would be so nice if somebody needed help and we don't have remote access to a computer, they could use their laptop and we can remote into their laptop and see whatever is going on. So it's a game changer, and for the $50, worth every penny in my opinion. So I will leave a link down in the description to where you guys can buy one of these. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like. If you're new to the channel and you like what you see, please subscribe. Maybe consider ringing the bell icon. That way you get notifications when I upload videos like this one. We usually post on Fridays. Anything relating technology is on the board. So if it's got a microprocessor in it or electronic circuitry, I'm probably interested in it. So it's always a fun, wild time. I am Dylan, the Technica's guy. I will see you lovely, beautiful people in the next video. But until that time, remember, keep it peaceful.